In my entire life, I was seeing people going ahead and using my body for their own pleasures. Boys used to come with me and follow me. I was being pushed into a center of more than 20 to 30 men. People were laughing, people were cringing, people were touching inappropriately on every part of my body. I wanted to end the entire effort of me, and that was when I wanted to use my Brahmastra. Hi, my name is Pathruni Chidananda Shastri and I'm from Hyderabad. I'm an Indian classical dancer, an Indian drag queen, and this is my story of finding my true identity with the help of dance. I was born and raised in a middle class South Indian Orthodox family. My father was a teacher and my mother was a housewife. In my early childhood, I used to watch television and adore Ramya Krishna as well as Madhuri Dixit and dress up and dance. I always loved dancing. I felt that when I dance, I'm feeling my true self. And that was when I realized that I was different. But being different comes with a cost. My difference was visible. As I grew up, I was thrown into extreme bullying. I used to be called names like Chakka, Hijra, Mamu, 50-50, 0.1. I was being mocked by my own friends. Boys used to come with me and follow me whenever I'm going ahead and using washroom and sneak peek and trying to check what exactly is my genitalia. When I went ahead and complained to my teachers, they said that, you know, you should stop dancing because dancing makes you unmanly and that's why you are being thrown to this bullying. It created a huge trauma and kind of sabotaged my entire childhood. It took me 21 years to realize and come with terms that I was different. Immediately after the decriminalization of Section 377, as a part of an interview, I came out to the world as a gender fluid person. And once the news was out, I got calls, messages, people coming ahead and kind of bothering me, asking me questions. I used to get numbers of tantrics as well as doctors who can cure me. And people used to tell me that this is a disorder. In my entire life, I was seeing people going ahead and using my body for their own pleasures. Even in my college days, I was being pushed into a center of more than 20 to 30 men, all of them watching at me. I was being shoved into a linen cotton, dirty gamcha wrapped as a ghungat and asked to dance on a cheesy number called as Sheela Ki Jawani. I could hear people coming ahead and screaming at me, telling, "Abe, nach! Basanti, nacho!" People were laughing, people were cringing, people were touching inappropriately on every part of my body. This entire idea of not accepting my own true identity made me baffled. I was not able to live as I want to live. And that made me extremely frustrating. And that was the time I realized that it's hard and important for oneself to stand up for themselves. And that was when I wanted to use my Brahmastra, dance. Dance became a change factor for me. I loved taking the entire phobia out of the society and induce with my dance and present it to the audience. But in order to do so, I had to start somewhere. And hence, I wanted to revisit my dance. Hence, I walked into Hyderabad and started searching for teachers across the city. So this was a male dancer from the city, and I enrolled for the class with him. It took around 6 to 7 months while my basic training was started. Initially, it was all good. But as and when the times were going on, my classes used to shift from afternoons to late night. I was being put for more solo classes. And one day, the day which kind of traumatized me to hell, even today, my teacher asked me to come to the dance class at 9 o'clock in the evening. I was the only person in the entire dance class. And he asked me to go and practice. While I'm practicing, I could sense his hand coming ahead and touching my private parts. This was the guru who was there to teach me and to make me sustainable with art, coming ahead and molesting me. I was shocked, terrified, and traumatized. I pushed him aside and walked out of that particular room. I started crying while I'm walking out of my way. And these are the moments I realized that my worth was something which was not correct in this particular society. I wanted to end the entire effort of me learning dance. I want to get rid of everything which is there inside my own world. I wanted to walk off with this shame which was being thrown to me time and again. As and when I sat back and realized what exactly is the thing which is triggering these people, what exactly is the visible thing which these people are attracted to me, what is the thing which they want to go ahead and consume out of me. And that was the time I realized that, you know, I would go ahead and start drag. Drag, a four-letter word which starts and stands for dress resembling a gender. And that was something which kind of attracted me to the core. I started going ahead and donning myself into drag. I wanted to be the one who is disgusted. I don't want myself to be beautiful. I wanted to be the scarecrow of the society. I wanted to reflect the hate, the phobia which people has thrown towards me in my entire life and present it onto my body. I wanted to break every rule which was told and said to me that boys should be in a certain way. I wanted to strike off every rule. Though drag gave me the strength to perform in front of people, it also came up with its own cons. In my initial days when I was going to have performing in the drag spaces, there were people throwing bottles, trash, calling me names and calling me a dustbin while I was going and presenting it. These were glass bottles which showered over to me, and I used to dance on these broken glass pieces and get my legs cut off. I used to carry these wounds and always see that this is the phobia which has been thrown to me time and again. Drag became my superhero. It became my superpower to give back to the society the hatred which is given towards me. I started representing the idea of anti-beauty, the idea of alternative beauty, the idea of disqualifying the idea of gender in the society. With drag, I was able to go and take off all the labels which are being put into everything in this particular world. When I perform drag, I become a different character. And that is something which brings an idea of hope whenever I'm going ahead and performing. With this hope, I started a website called is Dragvanti, which is India's first drag blog and India's first dance and drag school for people who would like to perform and learn the art of drag. These spaces have opened up avenues to connect with people, to teach the power of drag, and to ensure that everybody is valued in this particular society. I believe that everybody has a persona of drag in their own self. It just takes a little bit of time to unleash and then experience the power which is there within you. Remember, be yourself, because rest everybody is taken. Thank you.
आपको पता है जोश टॉक्स के हर स्पीकर में मैंने कुछ कॉमन क्वालिटीज नोटिस करी हैं। पहला, ये हिम्मत से और अपने डर से लड़के एक नया कदम लेते हैं, कुछ नया सीखने की कोशिश करते हैं। दूसरा, ये हर एक चीज़ में अपनी जी जान लगा देते हैं और तब तक प्रैक्टिस करते हैं और डटे रहते हैं जब तक अपना गोल ना हासिल कर लें। और आपको पता है ये दोनों चीज़ें आप भी घर बैठे कर सकते हैं। आप अपने इंग्लिश या वीक कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स का डर भगाने के लिए एक स्टेप ले सकते हैं, जोश स्किल्स ऐप डाउनलोड करके और राइट कोर्सेज परचेज करके। और इसमें हमारे प्रैक्टिस सेशंस के थ्रू आप अपने कॉन्टिन्यूस इम्प्रूवमेंट में लगे रह सकते हैं, पॉइंट्स जीत सकते हैं और लीडर बोर्ड में टॉप करके अपनी इंग्लिश को एकदम टॉप क्लास बना सकते हैं। तो बस इंतज़ार किसका है, इस टॉक से मिली मोटिवेशन को वेस्ट ना जाने दें। जल्दी से अपने इंग्लिश का डर भगाने के लिए एक स्टेप लें और अपने सारे सपनों को अचीव करें।